Hey guys, Pasty Boy here. Today I'm going to replace this gate behind me with a larger gate so I can get my riding mower in and out without having to remove the post that's there now. Okay, so currently this is the gate I have in here now. We can measure it up in a sec and see how big it is. What I've been doing for the past 11 years to get my riding mower in and out, and you may see some evidence of it here, is I've been removing this post. I've been pulling it up out of the ground and setting it up off to the side, opening this gate fully, and then I was able to get my riding mower in and out. Every year that came around, I contemplated putting a double gate here or putting a double gate on the other side of the house. The other side of the house, it doesn't have level ground, so that wouldn't make a lot of sense to put a level gate or a double gate on a slope. So, and you could see here, you know, like caught the chain link at the bottom occasionally on the mower deck, and you know, I had to stretch it back to shape. I've reduced this center clamp down to just the one instead of three. You can see the other two are just stuck over here. I don't even know what I did with the bolts for it, but nonetheless, that made it easier to get the post in and out. And now, over the years, I wasn't able to push it all the way back in this year. But in any event, I've decided to just put a larger gate in, a single larger gate, and let's take a look at that real quick. Okay, so this is the unit, Yard Guard Fit Right. And so this one fits any opening 24 to 72 inches wide. It's a 4 foot high gate and complete gate in the box. So it looks like it comes with two gate frame hinges, one gate fork latch, one all steel adjustable gate frame, and then these are the two pipes that you just cut to the size you need. A chain link fabric and one tie wires and nuts and bolts. And I thought this would come in handy and do the job for what I need. So if you look down here, then it says in this box is one all steel adjustable gate frame, chain link fabric, gate hardware, two gate frame hinges, one gate fork latch, one tie wire, truss, wires, and nuts and bolts. But not included is the gate post hinges. You must provide the correct gate post hinges for your application. So, looks like I'm gonna need to use my gate post hinges, which looks like it comes with these, but not these. So, good thing all I'm doing is removing this gate and the two posts and the link fabric from that side, and gonna span the new gate from end to end in the same fashion. Actually, I'm not removing this post either because I need that. So it'll go now from that post to that post, and we'll get a measurement of what we currently have and what we're going to have and how to do this. The current gate opening is 42 and a half. And we are going to be making it approximately 67 and a half. So this is the model information for 48 inch high up to 72 inch wide gate opening. All right, so the first thing I'm gonna do is remove this post here and the gate and the fencing from this side. All right, so let's go through some of the tools you'll need to do this job. Okay, so to remove the hardware that I'll have to remove on my gate, which may be very similar in yours, you'll need a half inch wrench. So I'm going to use this ratchet and socket. Deep well, because the bolts stick out quite a bit past the nuts. Tape measure, so you can measure the pipe that you have to cut to the size you'll need. A drill for fastening screws, and then you will need a screwdriver bit on that. You'll need a metal saw, So if you don't have a sawzall or a reciprocating saw with a metal blade, you could use a hacksaw. And a couple clamps that I'm gonna try to utilize here to keep the pipes firm and secure while I'm cutting. Pretty sure that's all we'll need. You will need something to drive in these self-tapping screws, which the head size is 5/16. So this is the back side of the gate here, as you can see. And we have three clamps with a nut on them that all need to be loosened and removed. And then this one at the top will also need to be removed because we'll no longer be using this clamp here. And then we will just pull this pipe right out of the ground. But in some cases, you'll probably have to loosen and remove all the clamps on this side as well. So that's all we got to do here. Switching over to an impact with a socket driver on it because it'll speed things way up. And then this post, I'm just going to pull right out of the ground. All right, now we just need to remove the gate. Now there's a bolt at the top and bottom of the gate that I need to loosen and remove. And then the whole gate will come off and be ready to start the new one. All right, just a heads up, I noticed we have 9/16 nuts on this side. So may have a combination of 1/2 inch and 9/16. All right, so technically you only had to loosen the top one because then you can kind of lift the gate off. So no sense to really do the bottom one if you have the same situation. Everything that I needed to remove is removed, and I left these on because we're gonna need them for the new gate because the new gate does not come with those. And so the next step we need to do is measure the opening from inside post to inside post. Okay, so here's a visual of what is in the box. So we've got the two rods that hold the chain fabric to each end of the gate, and these will be woven through the links on the chain fabric here. This is your top hinge side rail for the gate. This is your bottom side rail for the gate. And your two posts. All right, so I checked my dimensions from inside post to inside post, and it is 66 3/4, so I'm going to remove 5 1/4 inches from the spreader bars on the gate. So we got 5 1/4. So we're going to take this off. All right, so I broke out with the wooden horses because it'll be a little easier to clamp down. I clamped it at both ends. And it might come in handy when I'm putting the gate together to have two sets of horses here. All right, this is what's in the hardware package. We have our 6 gate clips, our gate latch, which is 3 pieces, the tie wires, frame hinges, female end. This is the adjustable truss wire, which will keep the gate nice and tight and true. Truss wire clamp. Got a truss wire corner hook. One is on this end. And this will be the one for the other end. Got the 5/16 inch head size here on the four self-tapping screws to connect the posts on the gate in the four corners. These are the gate rods. Okay, and these two bolts are part of the gate latch system. Oh, so I'm gonna guess that these are for those, and we shouldn't need to take anything off the old gate, but we'll take it one step at a time. So the next step is to put the top and bottom rails onto the looped pieces in these, and they are marked. And I'll point that out in a sec. Okay, so you gotta pay attention to these rails here on the side rails because they're marked top and bottom, and then you can assemble them and put your screws in properly. So this side says bottom, and this one says top. All right, so I've rearranged them in this fashion so I can start putting the ends together, and you'll see that they can only go one way because of the shape of the tubing here and the shape of the rails. You see that this concave area here is on the bottom because you don't want this on the top. I'm gonna slip together the bottom ends first. So if the gate was a full 72 inches, there'd be a hole on each end of the pipe. But since we had to cut some off, we'll have to put the two holes on this side. But they're self-tapping, so that should be a problem. All right, now it's time to put the screws in the corners. So they're self-tapping, careful. And I'm gonna do that in all four corners. All right, so I got all four of the corner screws in. Now, on the end where if you had to cut it, I decided to pre-drill at least through this part. Don't drill through this as well. I just drilled through this on the two sides that got cut off just to have it guide it a little better and make it easier. The self-tapping screws will go through it, but it's gonna take you a while. So I just grabbed a small drill bit that's smaller than the screw. Don't over tap that hole too much, and don't go through this at all. That way it catches real good. So next we're gonna put the wire from corner to corner with the hooks and tighten it up. I'm gonna measure it and make sure that it's 4 inches overall, less than the gate opening. 62 3/4. Now we're going to install the truss wire, and this end is going to go at the top hinge side. All right, a quick tip to get this in easily. Put it in like that, turn it, and you're in. All right, again, you're going to need a 5/16 driver of some sort to screw these nuts on. So we're going to pull this, loop it through, and tighten it on. Okay, so we'll put the hook in there, we'll wrap this around there, and then so these pieces have to go together like this, and the wire will go through here. If this helped you at all, please give the video a thumbs up. Check the links in the description. Check out the suggested videos here at the end of this video, and I thank you for watching. Take care.